And I do want to just do a couple of quick introductions and some general things. And then I'm actually going to come back and just tell a very quick story of why we're here. But I want to introduce very quickly some of the big shots who have come. I mean, this is really exciting to me. Peter Englesby is our Farmington Town Superintendent. Peter, yep, thank you. He's a Paul. We don't clap for Pauls. Okay? Sorry, Peter. Head. Office. Tom? Yeah, and Tom? You have something in your hand?
Yeah. So I brought, on behalf of Congressman, a congressional proclamation to commemorate this great ribbon cutting. So, Jonathan, on behalf of Congressman Chris Collins.
I also wanted to thank a couple of other co-workers. Jennifer Young, my longtime, long-suffering general manager of Pioneer Motion, is one of the tenants of this building. At the far end, you'll see the monstrous storage and facility that's there, as well as shipping. You know, she was gracious enough. She actually wanted the building in the first place. She was gracious enough to back off to allow us to use it for woodwork. And perhaps no more has suffered through this whole thing than Rob. Where's Rob? He's always in the back. Rob D'Alessandro, 20 years together, still loving each other tremendously. That's an inside joke, by the way, because usually we're fighting like cats and dogs or married couples, so I'm not sure which. But probably no one has suffered more than Rob in these last 2.5 years and his team. And since that February 2015 collapse of that building and that Saturday night phone call, don't worry, nobody's been hurt. You know, when a phone call starts that way, you're like, oh, what's going on? And so since then, they've gone from 16,000 feet down to 6,000 feet and have suffered through these last 2 years in a difficult, difficult condition. And right now, that's his reward. And so Rob and all of your coworkers, I think, here's a big round. Because this is really a story about a bucket of opportunities. That's what we call them. When that building collapsed, you know, everybody said, OMG, how are you going to survive? How are you going to actually make this thing work? You know, and what we saw instead of tragedy is we saw a bucket of opportunities. Those opportunities included the ability to finally bring all of our group, you know, and I love Shortsville, it's a great town, but it's a long way from here when you need to reach out and touch somebody immediately. So by bringing them here, we're now actually able to consolidate our community of companies, New Energy Works, Timber Framers, New Woodworks, our fine woodworking department, and Pioneer Millworks. And so we not only were able to pull it together, but what that does is allows that communication, that sense of community to continue to develop. It's easy to underestimate that importance. It also, though, at the same time, allowed us to build what we consider one of the most innovative buildings of its genre that anyone has gone to look at for a while. And in a lot of ways, it's like a crazy overbuilt, way too nice for woodworkers, but it's not. Because, you know, everybody says, well, let's just put up the cheapest building you can as quick as you can, you know, because it's just a fabrication shop. No, I don't think so. I think what we need to do is build amazing buildings that inspire us every day, our clients every day, as well as, in this case, use these most advanced European technologies. This is the first cross-laminated timber building, CLT building, that is fully cross-laminated timber, hybrid with timber, with heavy timber, the glulams that you see in there, building built in the New York State. You've heard it here, many of you have heard it here as the first place you've heard about this technology. In Europe, it's commonplace. In much of America, it will soon be more commonplace. Lower carbon footprint, faster installation time, higher R value, long lasting, easy to do. What we'll really see, and this is the exciting stuff, is we're really starting to see high rises. That's the exciting thing. And this is, you know, this is a one-story building. We could could have done it other ways, but we wanted to push this technology as well as the insulation technology of the spun fiber. I'm just going to hold this up real quick. This stuff is crazy, made in Poland. We just went over there. My coworkers Ty and Eric just in Poland learning about this technology of spun wood. This is actually just wood. That's all it is. Wood fiber. Spun, pressed, heated, and it's an amazing insulation. So that's how this building's been built. Could have done it cheaper, but somebody's got to cut the wake. And New Energy Works and Pioneer Monks have always been not afraid to cut the wake. So that's what we've done here. So that's probably, these last 2.5 years have been quite a trick. We wouldn't be here without Steve badgering me into buying enough insurance. I recommend you own enough insurance. And so we were able to do a good job here, as well as investment from Lions National, as well as the IDA's continued support, as they always have been. It is, and it's pretty exciting. Some of the fine woodworking that's going to be coming out of this place is some of the finest in America. I mean, no question about it. Right here in Ontario County. I know that. It's true. So anyway, I guess there's a ceremonial cutting, but so here's the story. We look at that and we go, forget it. Scissors, you know, we're timber framers. So, Steve Smigala, the insurance guy, you turn around. Because the heck with that stuff, right?
It is Halloween.
We're gonna do the more ceremonial.
Oh yeah, but I like it like that.
I saw it in So, we've got the ceremonial timber cutting. Oh, yeah.
Sorry.
Single one of you people who show up every day. All you folks out there who are eating all those pastries, all those folks out there who are up there drawing, you guys are actually the real heroes here. Make no mistake about it. So, come on in.